in addition to amnesty, were they offered anything else, like money or like vocational training or something to reintegrate back into society?
Well, I think the amnesty's major limitation was the integration, reintegration component. As a tool to encourage combatants to renounce rebellion and come back home, as a disarmament tool, it was excellent. What was offered to the combatants was a very meager reinsertion package. So basically, those who came back were given a handhold, a mattress, a saucepan, blanket, two jerrycans, and about 250,000 shillings, which is an equivalent of about less than $50, for them to get back into the community. It's called reinsertion. There were supposed to be follow-up vocational trainings and skilling to allow them to return to the community and be productive. According to the Amnesty Commission in their report in 2013, they had reintegrated, fully reintegrated, about 6,000 ex-combatants out of the 27,000. So about 21,000 of those who benefited from the amnesty certificate only got the reinsertion packages. But some of them also benefited from a number of non-governmental organizations who were doing a lot of work trying to reintegrate these other lots. In fact, for the case of the LRA, many of the children who returned would go through what we call reception centers, which were operated by World Vision. They had a project called Uganda Children of War Rehabilitation Project. There was the Gulu Support Children Organization, GUSCO. There were concerned parents, there were Caritas. These were all providing some basic skilling, basic counseling, basic reintegration assistance. But as we talk now, some of the formerly abducted still continue to face significant challenges. Majority have found their way back into the community. Those who were able to take on agriculture are doing pretty well. Those who got some forms of skilling are utilizing those skills. And we're not seeing major relapses or incidents of formerly abducted coming out and engaging in criminal activities or violence. So that shows that the community resilient and structures has kind of taken care of the majority of those who returned, even though they did not fully reintegrate them.